Hello, my name is Uncle Gouda and welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls 2. So I looked at the items we got, and most of them are one use items, healing, making more damage, having better luck. But this one, which I only got because I chose a explorer, is interesting. Stone activating a creation of Pharos the Vagabond. Vagabond? I don't know how it's pronounced in English, to be honest. Pharos was a legend to one of the lands, creating contraptions to help those in sincere and dire need. The scope of his travels was so wide that the Pharos had been mistakenly credited with many inventions that were crafted by others. Interesting. Maybe we will find the item or the contraption belonging to this item. Okay, so let's go here. No, that's the wrong way. Probably. Can I talk to you? Just laughing.
You must go on a journey. Well, I suppose if you find yourself at an impasse, to start again with a clean slate.
I skipped something.
Now go along.
Damn it! I have a little bit of an urge to kill them all, but I'm not going to do that.
This is a limbo.
Now.
A link between Drangleic and the outer world. Fair traveler, I know that you must have a story.
I like my monocle.
Such a place. This lost, decayed kingdom.
Yeah, interesting. If you didn't play any of the Souls games, the story is, and at least in the last games, I don't know how it is in this one. The story is not direct in your face. Here it is. It's item descriptions and such things. Oh yeah, the pre-order items. But I'm not going to use them. Because it would be too easy, probably. Maybe not. Maybe I will use them after my ass got kicked a couple of times. Human effigy, reverse hollowing. Oh! A warm, soft, shadow-like effigy. Use this item to reverse hollowing. It also weakens the links to other worlds, preventing invasions and most cooperation. Oh. Interesting, interesting. But already 20 minutes into the game and we are still alive. That is something I'm not used to. Burn probably increases the strength of my bonfire. So the bonfires are like save points. Let me get that item. Please let me. Here. Oh, just try it. Soul of the Lost Undead and a torch. So we will use the torch on the left hand. Oh, I thought it was an. Where's the torch? Oh, the torch is probably activated when I travel into dark places. Travel. Things best fit. Okay. Damn it. I used the item I did not want to use. So how are we using torches? I would like to know that. Can I scroll through them? No. Dual wielding. Strange. Can enter the mist. I hear enemies ahead. Through that mist. Can enter another mist. There's something big. Another mist. And you can go through here. Nope. I'm going to explore the mist. Which probably will kill me. Are you an enemy? Yes, you are! Search your surroundings. Okay, I'm gonna search my surroundings. I cannot reach you, can I? Dammit. Yes, I can reach you. Ah. And... bye-bye. Can fall down there. Okay, something. Damn it, missed him. I hurt you. Using the life gem. How are we going to go up here? Ah, this way. And as you can see, we nearly died already. But boy, it's dark in here. I'm not used without fighting without a shield. And hello, are you friendly? Are you? Oh! The second one surprised me. Damn it! Don't know where he came from. I definitely need a shield. Got an achievement. Welcome by Dark Souls, which means welcome to Dark Souls, you died. Okay, but I'm still a little bit confused about the torch thing. Can I only use my torches in? Item box. Okay, I can. Press the bonfire, light the torch. I'm blind. Okay, I'm going to light the torch. Yeah, a 5-minute torch, say thought. I'm going to light them all. Oh yeah, and because we died, we are a little bit hollow and don't look as good anymore. I hope the things stay lit him after we die. Which we will definitely do. Okay, so I can... Interesting. Target lock, yes. We already know that. I will probably use my torch again. Okay, so after the 5 minutes of lighting a torch, we need another one. That's good to know. Yeah, we know how to dash. We already did that before. Oh, I can hit with the torch too. And backstab. And over there, the blue-green thingy are our souls we lost when we died before. What's that? Another dagger. Okay, so we have normal dagger. And we could do wield. Roll. Switch the crit weapon. Yeah, I know that too. So we are going to try dual wielding when our torch is gone. Backstab. Damn it! I want my Estus Flask. So in the last Dark Souls game, Estus Flasks were items with which you could heal yourself. And they always refilled when visiting a bonfire, yes. So we heal ourselves with a life gem and enter the next mist. Move camera. Okay, so you have to fall down here. Boop. Soul of the Nameless Warrior. Let's sconces? Okay. With the torch. Oh, nearly fell down there. Yeah, two-handing good one. Ah! Press the wrong button. Fortunately, the enemy attacked me, or else I would have used my life jab. Jump! That did not work as intended. Damn it. Normally I jump there, but as you can see, not this time. Okay, now I want to dual wield. Doesn't seem to be that useful. Just the same attacks with both weapons. Wield right hand weapon two-handed. Weird left hand working to my left. Oh, interesting. But I wonder how dual wielding is usable. What? Why? 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 Okay, I have to train that jump. In Dark Souls 1, I always jumped, but as it seems, I am doing something wrong. Okay, but I'm all out of time for this episode, so if you like my video, like, comment and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye!